could do that.
For this purpose, we need a surface and also we need a panel fan. Let's go to 2D and let me go to the masking and side tab, and from here click on in place mask, and let me name this to facade. This is not really important. You can name it whatever you want. And from here, let me create a reference line in drawn face mode, and let me create a... The dimension is not really important because we are going to create a panel, create some panels that are really, that are fully parametric and they can adapt in whatever surfaces. Okay, let me make it a little bit taller, and from here too, let me change it to shaded mode. Okay, it is great. Let's go to the file menu, from new, go to the families, and from here, I'll select your appropriate standard. I'm going to use English metric. And from here, we need to use this environment metric curtain panel pattern list. Click on open, and then you are good to go. But before that, we are going to use rectangle checkerboard surfaces. For example, let me select this surface here. Let me convert this to a device surface, and then change the panel mode to rectangle checkerboard. Okay, this is great, and it will place my panels like this. One panel, one empty, one panel, one empty. Okay, great, let's go to the 3D and to the family environment. The first step is you need to change this panel to a checkerboard too. Okay, let me put it on this. This is great. And the next step is you need to create a spline to these points from here, and again something between these. Let me select both of them and convert them to a reference. It is great. Then we need to place 4 points in these lines. Make sure it is on drawn face. It is really important in this family, so don't miss this. Okay, let me place these 4 points here. And then the next step is when you create a point on a curve or on a line, you will have this parameter normalized curve parameter. It is between 0 to 1. 0 will be here and 1 will be here, but this is kind of tricky because it will recognize in different ways, for example from beginning or from the end. And for example, this point is showing 0.8, means it is getting the beginning from here, but this point is getting 0.1. it is great, it is working right, but some situation we need to change the measure from to ending to be the exact parameters with this. Okay, let me make it more clear. I'm going to create a parameter to create some points with exact measurements from these points, from here to here, from here to here. So here it is great, it is on 1.13. it is great for me. Let me create a parameter here. This is going to be a type parameter OF1, and great, and let me put it on maybe dimensions, and then click on OK. Okay, I'm going to assign this parameter to this ones too. Let me make it OF1. Okay, this is good, but for these two, if I would put this on OF1, it will be not really appropriate because it's going to put this point on this point. My intention is not that. I'm going to create an exact offset from here to here too. So the trick here is to prevent from creating two parameters is to make the measure from to end and then assign your parameter here. Okay, this is really tricky, I know, but this is a point that you can get in the next steps. Okay, this is great. Let me create a splint through these points from here to here, from here to here, and from here to here. Okay, that's great. And let me convert this line to reference line. Okay, this is great. I'm going to create some points that are above these points because we are going to give it some solid forms. To do that, you need to place some points, but this time you need to put it on drawn work plane. You need to set your work plane to here, place a point on your work plane. Okay, this is great. Then set your points to this one, place a point here, and so on. Set your work plane here, make sure it is on drawn work plane, put your point, and then set your work plane here, place your point. Okay, now we have these points. We can bring them up, and also they are associated with these points. When these points move, the upper point will move with the bottom point. So it is really important for us. And let me bring this point up too, and here too. Okay, great. And for these two, let me create a height parameter for all of them. So let me select all of them, and from here in offset, let me create a new parameter for this H1, and I'm going to make it a type parameter, and let me put it on dimensions, and okay. And let me assign this parameter to this one too. Okay, great. But for these two, I'm going to create a H2 parameter because I'm going to create a slope panel. Let me select this one and let me create a new parameter for here, H2. This is great. And let me assign it to these points too. Okay, that's great. Let me change my H2 parameter to a smaller one, maybe 300, and let me click on okay. You can see the results now. Okay, let me create a line from here to here, from here to here. First, you need to create the structures. The forms are just appearance thing between these line structures. So the important part is to create a great structure. Okay, that's great. From here to here. Okay, this is great. We need to convert them to reference lines too. And let me do the exact thing here too. Let me create some points from here too. Let me create some lines from here to here. From this point to this point. From this point to this point, let me convert them to reference lines, and then place your points and do the exact thing with the upper face too. Let me place my points, make sure it is on drawn face, place 4 points here, here, and here, and let me make it. Make this measure to the end, and from here, make this to the end too. And let me select both of these four, all of these 4 points, and assign the exact parameter we assign to this. This is better for us and will be much smoother. Let me change the parameter to OF1. Okay, now you can see these are in the exact place with this. Let me create some lines between these points from here to here, from here to here, and so on. Then you need to convert all of these lines to reference lines. Okay, now we have our, let me change our reference line to a better place and let me turn off the point. Now we have our structures. Then we need to create our forms. Then let's create our first form. Let me select these four and these fours together and make a solid front. Okay, let me create and create form. Let me select these four. Sorry, we select the wrong ones here, here, and here. And now you have a solid one. Let's go to the wireframe mode and let's create a void in between them. Make it a void form, and then let's go back to the shaded mode, and you can see we have this. Let me select all of them and let me filter them to curtain panel solid. And let me create a material parameter for this. From here, let's create a material parameter for this panel. Mat. That's great. And then the last part is we are going to create a glass here. So I need to select all of these and create a form, but this one is going to be a surface. And from below you can see these ticks. Okay, let me select this one and let me create a material parameter for these, which I'm going to call it glass mat. And then it is great for me. Let me save this family and I'm going to put the family on my Patreon. You can go to my Patreon page and download all of the files. Okay, this is the panel. Great. And then let me load this to my project. And now let's go to the 3D in our project and let me assign our panels to here. Okay, this is great. First of all, let me change my materials here. Maybe glass to a glass one and solid to a solid one, which is really obvious. Let me create a new material and then let me assign a material from here, glass. And maybe blue green one. From here, click on use and appearance to, and for the panel, let me assign a white material, maybe appearance ceramic, maybe ice white. But I'm going to create this as a matte material on here using the appearance tool. This is great for me, and now you can see it better. Okay, when we say parametric, what is our point? Let me change the numbers here. For example, let me put it on 5 to 5. You can see it will change and it will adapt to the new dimension. Also, you can change the dimensions too. How? You need to go to the edit type and let me change the OF one to maybe 0.4. You can see this, it's going to change exactly as you want. Let me create some things here. Maybe this is, should be 5, this should be 2. You can see with just one family we can create infinite combinations. Now let me test some different combinations here too, and also you can assign this to this face too. It is not, it is completely parametric, and you can see the power of parametric things in this part. Let me create it to 8 to 5. And you can see the greetings in our family. And also you can change the numbers too. The greetings is here. Let me put it on maybe 0.2. And you can see the change in all of our families in this great way. I hope this video was helpful.